Hello, my name is Jeff Kavanagh with KE2 Therm Solutions. In this video, I'll cover the steps for wiring the KE2 Low Temp or KE2 Adaptive Controller for use with a door switch. The first step is to remove the four screws holding the display cover of the controller to the enclosure. Once the display cover of the controller is removed, find the connector labeled AUX 1 or AUX 2. Either connector can be configured for the door switch. However, when using a KE2 adaptive control, AUX 1 is defaulted for second coil sensor, so AUX 2 should be used. This is where we will connect the two-wire door switch. Either wire can be connected in either position for this device. Once the two wires are connected, place the display cover back on the enclosure and secure with the four screws. The final step will be configure AUX input on the controller menu to recognize the door switch. Once configured, the controller will save energy and eliminate nuisance evaporator icing, as the fans will shut off and the system will pump down when the door is left open. After 90 minutes, an alarm will be initiated and the refrigeration will turn back on if the door is still open. For information on configuring a controller for use with a door switch, please see our video number 43 on how to configure the KE2 Low Temp or KE2 Adaptive Control for use with the door switch. For more information, please visit our website or contact our tech support line.